Hello students, now I'm going to start question number 10 of exercise 3.3. Now question number 10 says, explain how this figure is a trapezium. Which of its two sides are parallel? So here we have a quadrilateral KLMN. We will have to explain how this figure is a trapezium and which of its two sides are parallel. Now we know that trapezium is a quadrilateral with a pair of parallel sides. So here we will have to check which of two sides are parallel. So if you extend KN line and LM line, then it will meet at a point. So these two lines cannot be a parallel line because parallel lines never meet each other. Now if you extend NM line and KL line, then LM is the transversal. We know that if two lines are there and one transversal line cut these two lines, then the sum of interior angle on the same side of transversal, so this is the transversal line and these two angles are on the same side of transversal, is, if the sum of this is 180 degree, then the line, say L1 and L2, are parallel. So we will have to prove that if the sum of two interior angles is 180 degree, then the lines are parallel. Now here, NM and KL, these two are lines, and ML is a transversal, and L and M are the two interior, this L and M are the interior angles on the same side of transversal. So let us check the angles L and M make 180 degree or not. If the sum of this angle is 180 degree, then the lines NM and KL are parallel lines. So angle M plus angle L is, angle M is 100 degree and angle L is 80 degree, and the sum of this is 180 degree. Now since the sum of these two angles is 180 degree, so lines NM parallel to KL, and since one pair of sides are parallel in a quadrilateral, so a quadrilateral KLMN will be a trapezium. So we will write KLMN is a trapezium. Okay. Now coming to next question. Now question number 11 says, find measurement M for measurement of angle C. That means we will have to find this angle in figure if AB parallel to DC. Now here it is given that the lines are parallel. Okay, AB parallel to DC, and this BC is the transversal line, and this angle and this angle, that means angle B and angle C, are the interior angles on the same side of transversal. So since AB parallel to DC, okay, since AB line parallel to DC line, so angle, the sum of angle B and angle C will be 180 degree. Why? The sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal. Okay, so here angle B is given 120 degree, so just put the value there, and angle C we have to find, so plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. So what will be the value of angle C? It's 180 degree minus 120 degree, so 0 minus 0 is 0, 8 minus 2 is 6, so angle C will be 60 degree. Okay. So this was all about question number 11. Thank you, students.